When Donald Trump became president of the United States, he became the most powerful man in the world. That notion, though, has been constantly tested ever since he took office. Perhaps the most unexpected example of that has been his inability to shut down a woman called Stormy Daniels. She is the stripper and porn star who claims to have had a sexual encounter with Trump back in 2006. But when the president accused her of lying, she hit back in the most extraordinary way. Stormy Daniels refuses to go away, and that's because she says she is not a liar.
Who am I? I am Stormy.
Face to face with Stormy Daniels.
I'm a very ordinary person put into a very extraordinary situation.
Right now, this adult entertainer is one of the most talked about women in American politics.
90 seconds of my life of making a bad decision with a goofy looking TV guy is not what I wanted to be defined as.
Do you think you've got the president of the United States running scared?
He's not smart enough to run scared.
He has never thought women like me matter.
It's been a bruising battle.
It's all fake news. It didn't happen.
Ever since Stormy Daniels shaped up to Donald Trump, she's been jailed, taken to the brink of financial ruin, and faced hundreds of death threats. Truth is, Stormy Daniels is as tough as they come.
I'm not a liar. And I am not a gold digger. And I did not do this because I'm starved for attention. I just wanted to stand up for myself and set the record straight and prove I wasn't lying. I think I've pretty effectively done that. You know, the message is very clear. Don't mess with me.
You would expect Stormy Daniels to be a creature of the night. But ironically, it's out here in the wilds of Wyoming, far from the city lights, where she's most at home. And where she can escape the whirlwind over the very brief sexual encounter Stormy claims she had with Donald Trump.
Together, we will make America great again.
It was 90 seconds that I never thought about really again. It doesn't define me except now to everyone else it somehow does. Which is really disappointing.
This presidential sex saga that refuses to go away actually started 12 years ago in July 2006. Back then, Donald Trump was a loudmouth businessman and TV celebrity. And Stormy Daniels was a well-known porn star and stripper. Their lives collided at a celebrity golf tournament where a flirty conversation led to a dinner invitation at Trump's penthouse.
I'd met lots of famous people. I wasn't intimidated. I was amused and entertained and curious, but I wasn't like, oh my God, peace of my heart. No, I was like, whatever.
You just saw that as another rich man, I guess.
Didn't even matter that he was rich. He was just another male and I was in a little skimpy outfit and have huge boobs.
Stormy's account of the night, details that remain deeply disputed by Donald Trump, make for pure tabloid joy.
Oh, he was a pain in the ass for the first 20 minutes. Because at first he was very much the caricature that you see on TV and that I was, you know, expecting.
So you walked in the door and you basically met a very domineering man.
Yeah.
And you had to sort that out.
Oh, yeah, and I sorted it very effectively and swiftly.
Well, you slapped him on the backside with a copy of a magazine with
yes.
his face on the cover.
Mm-hmm.
When you did that, you didn't think...
I remember thinking that moment, okay, well, here's the great story I came for. I just spanked Donald Trump with a magazine and now I'm going to leave. But then, you know, he became nice. And I think that we shared a mutual curiosity, genuine curiosity about the business aspects of each other's lives. It was just all very interesting.
But it ceased to be interesting when you went to the bathroom.
Yeah, and that was a couple hours in, which is why I was so blindsided, because at least the last hour and a half that we were talking, It was just like you and I are talking now. How he mentally got from A to B, I still don't know.
But when you emerge from the bathroom, he's down to his wife fronts and socks. Is that right?
Yes.
It still makes you laugh.
You know what? I have to applaud his confidence.
According to Stormy, what followed was the least impressive sex she's ever had. Why did you have sex with him?
I have no idea.
Even after all this time?
Yeah, I have no idea. Either I was in the right place at the right time, or I was the wrong place at the wrong time. And my opinion of that changes about every 20 minutes.
You didn't expect he would proposition you?
He didn't proposition me.
No, I guess he didn't actually say anything.
Yeah, no, he didn't. And he didn't try to pay me, which is one of the things that's very frustrating, that people assume that I was paid for that night, and I absolutely wasn't. And I didn't even turn down money. He didn't even offer.
And if he had?
I would have definitely said no and been way more upset.
Yes, you say you weren't a victim.
No, I'm not a victim. I'm a victim of myself. I never said, no, don't touch me, or I'm leaving, or I don't want to do this. That absolutely did not happen.
Stormy claims after their liaison, Trump stayed in contact for the next 18 months, with promises he'd make her a contestant on his show, The Celebrity Apprentice. But when that failed to happen, the relationship fizzled. Stormy says she forgot about her night with Trump until 5 years later, when in 2011, the story turned up on a gossip website. So this story really started without you.
Oh, absolutely. I was completely caught off guard.
And then you had to try and...
damage control. And reclaim
catch
and take power. Yes.
Stormy suspects the story had been leaked by a former partner. And so, to set the record straight, she decided to give her own interview to a tabloid magazine. Despite passing a lie detector test, the magazine chose not to publish her story. A short time later, Stormy claims a man approached her in a car park and threatened her for talking.
Like, it was extremely traumatic and scary.
Is that the first time you became frightened?
Yes. Oh, for sure.
But now you've poked the bear, it seems.
Oh, I didn't even know there was a bear. Because keep in mind, he was just a silly guy on TV who did cameos on wrestling and, you know, movie. Like, he was a kind of a joke.
Stormy Daniels moved on. But by 2016, Donald Trump had set his sights on the White House. Amidst his campaigning came allegations of sexual misconduct and an audio tape of Trump talking about his approach to women.
Whoa. I did try and fuck her. She was married.
That's huge news, Sarah.
You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab him by the pussy.
Donald Trump described it as locker room talk and apologized. But it was damaging. 2 weeks later, Stormy Daniels was offered hush money of $130,000 from Trump's personal lawyer, Michael Cohen.
Which was the best day of my life. They could have given me $10. And it would have just been the icing on the cake. Like, I was just excited that, like, fuck yes, like, no one's gonna know. This is perfect.
Finally, this is gone.
Finally. But that there is a record of them acknowledging this happened so that if something terrible happened to me or my family, there are witnesses, there is a trace. You know, they can't hurt me because this deal has been made. I am protected. And at the same time, no one's ever gonna find out.
Coming up, the fight back.
I was being ripped to shreds and backed into a corner.
Stormy gets angry. Can you remember the moment when you thought,
fuck this guy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Very clearly.
That's next on 60 Minutes.
This is the place you feel most comfortable, probably. Around horses, huh?
Yeah, for sure. It's always been my escape.
To understand Stormy Daniels, it's important to know where she came from.
You know, when I was younger and I started riding, it was a very basic way to get out of, you know, bad neighborhood and, you know, horses don't judge you. It's like the famous, I think it's Winston Churchill, something about the outside of a horse is good for the inside of a man.
She was born Stephanie Clifford in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, raised in a tough neighborhood by parents with little money and not much more love.
I make the joke that I'm convinced my mother stole me from the rich couple at the mall when they weren't looking.
Stephanie's childhood was traumatic. At 9, she was repeatedly raped by a neighbor and then not believed when she reported it.
No one ever cared about me or what I did or what happened. So that was the hard part, I think.
That's devastating, I think, as a child.
When you're very small, yeah. But it, you know, you have two options, let it break you or let it make you stronger.
Stephanie was caught in a cycle of poverty. But that changed when, at 17, and while still at school, she landed a job in a strip club. It was where Stephanie transformed into Stormy.
It was a place that gave you more than money, though, wasn't it? You found love and support.
Yes, for sure. It gave me independence, freedom, friends who weren't judgmental.
You do cite a significant day, and I think it was July 9th, 1999. Mm. It was the day you got enough money.
To get thunder and lightning.
Thunder and lightning are?
My breast. Yes.
And you don't regret that?
Absolutely not. Best decision ever.
Even though they're not quite what you were expecting?
No, they're bigger than I originally ordered, but they've served me very well.
Hi, I'm Stormy Daniels.
With the arrival of thunder and lightning, Stormy Daniels' career took off in a big way.
We should demystify the business a bit. It is not prostitution.
No, absolutely not. I'm not saying that it doesn't happen, you know, but I personally have never been involved in it.
Your fans were adult white males, mm-hmm. 45 to 65, I think you said, Republicans.
Mostly, yeah. I mean, that's the look I have. Blonde hair, blue eyes, big boobs. You know, that was my demographic. We're, you know, middle-aged, upper-class, white men.
Which might explain how Stormy Daniels came to meet up with Donald Trump on that fateful night in July 2006.
You know, of course, the President of the United States denies all this.
He can deny it all he wants. If I was going to lie about having sex with someone famous, Brad Pitt, here we go. You know, I mean, I would pick somebody way less embarrassing than Donald Trump. Are you kidding? Now no man is ever going to want to date me. I'd have at least picked, like, you know, somebody cool.
We want Trump! We want Trump!
In 2016, 10 days before the election, Stormy Daniels was paid $130,000, allegedly to stay quiet about her night with Trump. But then, in January this year, she claims Trump's team pressured her to sign another document denying she ever had sex with Trump.
So what turned you? Can you remember the moment when you thought, no.
Fuck this guy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, very clearly.
What was that day?
The day that I went on Jimmy Kimmel, January 30th.
Please welcome Stormy Daniels.
Remarkably, instead of keeping quiet, Stormy claims Trump's camp wanted her to start talking, but to say she'd never had sex with the president. It made for very awkward late-night television.
Did you sign this letter that was released today?
I don't know, did I?
Wait a minute, that you can say, right?
But that does not look like my signature, does it?
It doesn't look like your signature. So you're saying perhaps this letter was written and released without your approval.
Were you bullied?
Yes. Not, hey, sign this or we're going to break your kneecap with a baseball bat, but it's in your very best interest for you and your family if you just sign this now.
Do you think the president is watching right now? I like to imagine him.
I don't want to imagine him.
After her strange appearance on the Jimmy Kimmel show, the gloves came off. Stormy and Donald went to war.
I wanted to defend myself. I was being ripped to shreds and backed into a corner and not allowed to stand up for myself.
See, Donald Trump has been fairly straightforward in tweets, of course. He says that, in essence, that you've told false and extortionist accusations about an affair. And he has said that the story of being threatened mm-hmm. is all a con job.
Those two tweets were, especially when he called me a con job, is one of the, you know, I guess I should thank him for encouraging me to write a book.
Do you think you've got the President of the United States running scared?
He's not smart enough to run scared.
What is he?
An egotistical lunatic at this point.
Coming up, more embarrassing revelations.
Yeti head.
That was just me being mean.
Why Stormy is telling all.
I want him to be investigated just like he was you or me or anyone else.
And Trump's surprising reaction.
The things that would be normally utterly embarrassing, humiliating, to Donald Trump, not necessarily so.
That's next on 60 Minutes. This week, Stormy Daniels launched a tell-all account of her time with Donald Trump.
Stormy for president.
Oh, God.
And with it, a salvo of excruciating observations that zeroed in on President Trump's dignity.
She talks about Donald Trump's anatomy, his performance in bed, neither of which are very flattering.
He knows he has an unusual penis. It has a huge mushroom head.
He's calling it smaller than normal and oddly shaped.
As quotes, like the mushroom character in Mario Kart.
Why did you do that?
To prove that I'm not lying.
You see that as evidence.
Oh, absolutely. Let's just hope that that's never called as an exhibit in court. But if it was, I win.
And Yeti hair.
That was just me being mean.
So you feel you had to go to this
I felt like I was
level.
Forced there, yeah. And you know, I justify it in a way to myself. And even now, saying, like, this is a man who said much worse things about women multiple times. So here's a taste of your own medicine, asshole.
His first instinct is always, does it make me look good? Does it make me look bad? And so the things that would be normally to most people on the planet, utterly embarrassing, humiliating. To Donald Trump, not necessarily so.
So he wouldn't be humiliated?
Oh, goodness, no.
Fascinating, I must say.
If anyone has an insight into the unique mind of Donald Trump, it's author Mark Fisher.
He believes that scandal is something you can use to your advantage, that any coverage is better than no coverage, and that a little bit of notoriety can go a long way.
A senior editor with The Washington Post, he spent long hours talking with Trump for an in-depth biography.
And when he's under attack, what is his modus operandi?
His response to attack is always counterattack. Hit back 100 times harder than you've been hit. That's his mantra.
It's all fake news. It's phony stuff. It didn't happen.
No racist police!
Donald Trump has spent a lifetime dealing with critics, the newest of whom gather outside the White House to voice their disgust.
We are done with corrupt men who think that they can grab whatever they want.
But remarkably, Mark Fisher says this stoush between Stormy and Trump is most probably giving the president secret pleasure.
To Donald Trump, he is likely upset by the fact that he can't control her. But he also is likely getting some satisfaction out of the idea that people out there will think that he's yet again, even at this advanced age, a rogue playboy who can get this beautiful woman who he thinks of as somehow a symbol of his prowess.
I've still got it.
Right, right, exactly.
Is Stormy Daniels his equal in that she's the street fighter too?
I think Stormy Daniels is very much Donald Trump's equal as both street fighter and as someone who understands that their career is indistinguishable from the show. And so he probably has a grudging respect for her because she knows how to use the things that would normally devastate a person to turn them to her advantage. That's the story of his whole career.
Which makes it all the more remarkable that just days after her book's release, Stormy now feels her description of the president's privates was a step too far.
So I was very angry in writing that. And now that it's, you know, the book is out and people are reading about it and it's all over the internet, I actually feel pretty terrible about it.
Do you?
Yeah.
Why?
because it's, in a way, it's body shaming.
Did you want to humiliate him?
No, absolutely not. Which is why I feel a little conflicted about the book.
You wanted to hurt him?
No, I did not want to hurt him. My intention was for people to stop hurting me.
It could be argued that Stormy Daniels is inflicting damage of her own. Trump's then personal lawyer, Michael Cohen, has recently admitted paying Stormy hush money and claims it was at the direction of the president. According to Stormy, Trump's camp has also offered to settle an ongoing legal battle, something she has rejected.
I thought a couple weeks ago that I was done.
But?
Instead, I didn't accept the offer, and we're gonna move forward legally. I can't really say what our plan is, obviously. You know, it's confidential.
It's been said, and it probably is true, one of the reasons you are able to cut through, that you are able to withstand the storm, is because you can't be scandalized.
The entire universe has seen my butthole. Like, I'm pretty hard to embarrass. Did you hear that thud? That was probably my publicist fainting.
I haven't.
It's one bag Google click away. I have nothing to hide, and I don't have a family that I'm concerned about embarrassing. Like, I don't care.
Everything's on the table.
Everything's on the table. I don't think that porn or nudity or sex is bad, so I have no guilt there. And I'm not really religious, so I'm not afraid that I'm gonna go to hell because I admitted to fornicating.
Stormy Daniels Day in the city of West Hollywood.
Stormy Daniels is making the most of her moment in the spotlight.
And this community has a history of standing up to bullies and speaking truth to power.
She's been given a voice, and for a woman who might once have dared not speak, being heard is very liberating.
Do you like him?
No.
Do you hate him?
No.
What do you feel about him?
Conflicted. Because he's doing really, every day I hate him a little bit more. But it's not on a personal level. Now my opinion of him, I would say, is 95% based on him as a political leader and the president.
Do you ever feel sorry for him?
Yes. Yes, sometimes I do. Because I think that perhaps he's in a position that he was unprepared to be in and he's struggling with it. And that's difficult for anyone. But at the same time, you know, he continues to make bad choices and treat people like shit. I want him to be held accountable for the things he's done and that he's doing and the bad decisions he's making and for all the people that he's hurt.
So you want to bring him down?
Yes, I want him to be investigated and through due process and held accountable just like he was you or me or anyone else. And if found guilty and evidence supports it, then absolutely take him down in flames.
But you're not done yet.
But I'm not done yet.
And you're not done with Donald Trump?
No.
He hasn't seen the last of you?
No. Only from now on, I'll have my pants on.
Hello, I'm Liz Hayes. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9 Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.